Next is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 6th chapter, text 11 through 19, given by His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on September 7th, 1966, in New York.
In India, there are some selected places, very sacred place, and the yogis, generally, they go there and sit there alone in a sacred place and as prescribed in the Bhagavad Gita and perform there. The yoga asana cannot be executed in a public place, so that in assembly. Now so far, this kirtan is concerned, just like we have performed just now kirtan. This is called Sankirtan. Sankirtan means Bahuvi Nirithva Kirtayati Iti Sankirtanam. When we sit down, many people together, when Lord Chaitanya was performing this kirtan ceremony 500 years before, he had in each group 16 persons taking part in kirtan, and thousands of people are singing with them. Now, this participation in the kirtan is very easily possible. But so far, the yoga system is concerned, that is required any very secluded and sacred place, silent, that is required. It is this clearly said here that sucho deshe pratisthapra thiram asanam atmanah. One has to place himself in a sacred place, in a silent place, then yoga system is possible. Now comparatively, at the present moment, if you have to practice yoga, then strictly, according to the rules and regulations, you have to leave your home. You have to go out in a secluded place, in a sacred place, and there you have to execute the performance of meditation and yoga. At home it is not possible. So far Bhagavad Gita is concerned, it is a book of authority. It is recommended here that you should find out a place, suitable place for executing yoga. But here, this is also yoga. This is called bhakti yoga. Savanam kirtanam, bhakti yoga, they have got 9 different processes. Out of that, the first two, savanam kirtanam, hearing and chanting. I am chanting, you are hearing, you are chanting, I am hearing. This is the process. Holy name of Sri Krishna. So everyone can take part in it. But in the yoga system, a particular man, if he is expert, if he is able, if he can leave alone from home in a secluded place, then perfection of yoga can be attained. It cannot be attained in a city, in a very good assembly, by exercising gymnastics. No, that is not recommended in the Bhagavad Gita, at least. We may do that according to one's own way, but that is not the system recommended by the Bhagavad Gita. Tattakagamanakritya jato chittendra kriya upavishya asane junjyad yoga atma visiddhaya. The whole process is yoga system, whole process is to purify mind. Purify. Atma visiddhaya. And what is that purification? The purification is that I am pure spirit. I am not this matter. And under material contact, I am identifying myself that I am matter. I am thinking of myself, I am this body. This is impurity of my existence. And it is clearly said here that one has to realize his constitutional position, that he is not this matter. No water. Atma Vishishaya Upavishya Asane Junjya Yogam Atma Vishishaya. The whole process is to purify. Now this purification process, if somebody is not able to go outside home and find out a secluded place, to do things that his purification of his existence will not be possible? No, it will be possible. That is the contribution of Lord Chaitanya. He says that Harinnama, Harinnama, Harinnamaiva kevalam, kalo nasteva, 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 gati rannatha. Lord Chaitanya says, in this age is called Kwal, age of Kwal. So he says that in this age especially, of course, this chanting of holy name of Krishna or God, that is always throughout the history of Vedic literature you find. But especially in this age it is recommended. Why? Now, kalo nasteva, 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 gatirannatha. Three times he has said that there is no other alternative, there is no other alternative, there is no other alternative. Nasteva means there is no other alternative. This is the only problem. This is Harinnama, Harinnama, Harinnamaiva kevala. He says that in this age, simply chanting of God's name, that is the only process, that is the only process, that is the only process. And there is no other alternative, there is no other alternative, there is no other. Why does he say three times? Now, three times means that this yoga process was possible in the Satya Yuga, Kriteja Dhyato Vishnu. In those days, people could very easily and nicely meditate upon the Vishnu. Sometimes it is recommended the yoga system is meditation in the void. But we do not find in the Vedic literature that yoga system is meditation on void. No. It is meditation on Vishnu that will be explained in the Bhagavad Gita. Now, after sitting in a secluded place, in a sanctified place, and according to the sitting arrangement with tiger skin or deer skin and straw, as it is recommended, then one should sit down there. He should not change his asana, sitting place. Then after sitting, what he has to do? He says, samam kaya giros. Sayam samankaya siro grivan dharan achanam sira. Now, one has to sit down straight. One has to sit down straight so that his skull, his head and the body and everything should be straight like that. Samankaya griva. Griva means his neck. The neck and the skull and the body should be in one straight line. Samam kaya siro grivam dharan achalam, and should not move or sit down like this. Samprekha nasika agram, and one has to see the top portion of the nose. Not that one has to close his eyes completely, no, then he cannot see. Sampreksha nasika agram. You have to see the upper portion of the nose. That means, if you have seen in some of the yogic societies, they close the eyes completely And some of them, about 50% of them, are kneeling, sleeping. Regular. Because as soon as you close your eyes, and if you have no subject matter to think, and you have been forced to meditate, you do not know to what to meditate, then the next result is sleeping and nothing. That is practical. So one has to sleep very Somebody was inquiring here. Of course, some of the students, they were sleeping. So he was sarcastic. He said, are they sleeping or meditating? So I said, yes, they are meditating by lying down. Yes. So sometimes meditation goes on in sleeping. No, that is not the process. You cannot close your eyes completely. Then you invite the queen sleep, and she will capture it. Whole process will be like that. Here it is said that in order to keep yourself alive, you have to always see the upper portion of your nose. Samprekṣa nāsikādāgraṁ saṁ diśaśca anabalopāṁ. And you cannot see that who is coming there, who is here, some tiger is coming or something is coming. No fear, because you are put in a Himalaya, in a secluded place and a sanctified place. So you haven't got to, for any other reason, you haven't got to, to move your neck. And that is not possible in the society. You must have to go in a secluded place. There are so many disturbances. That one disturbance is there, and I have to look who is there. This is the position here. But here it is said that you cannot move your head. You have to sit down straight. That your neck and skull and body should be in one straight line. And you have to see the upper portion of your nose always. That is the system.
Prasantatma vigata bhi brahmachari vratesikaha.
Then one should be undisturbed in mind. A man who is always disturbed in mind, he cannot perform yoga. That is not possible. And vigata bhi. Bhi means fear, fearfulness. One who has no fear. If he has got fear, then how he can go out of home in the jungle? That is not possible. That is another qualification for executing yoga. Not only for yoga, any person who is trying to elevate himself in the spiritual land, he has to become fearless. Vigata bhi. And brahmachari vrate sita. Brahmachari vrata means celibate. No sex life at all. Complete depravity. Brahmachari. Brahmachari vrata. Vrata means with a bhav. That I'll have no sex life with a bhav. Such person can exist with yoga.
Prasantata vigata bhi brahmachari vrata sita manas sangyamya.
When the atma is, there is no demand, when you have no demand, then your mind is naturally becomes controlled.
Manas sangyamma machitya.
Now doing all these things, the next item is machitya. Krishna says mach to transfer the whole thinking to Krishna or Vishnu, not vacant. Machitta. So, if that is the system of yoga, machitta, yukta asita matpara, machitta and yukta asita matpara, always thinking of me or this, always thinking. So now that one who is in Krishna consciousness, he gets the opportunity of the highest yoga system, but he hasn't got to take the trouble of the process. That is the beauty of Krishna consciousness. Yes, the whole thing is coming down, the Lord says, maschitta. The mind should be engaged in Vishnu, the yogi, the real yogi who goes to the forest, to the secluded place. He thinks of the Chaturbhuj Vishnu, that will be explained here. Mana sangyamma machitya jitta asita matpara jinyanneva sadatmanam yogi niyatamanasa jinyanneva, by prosecuting the process of yoga in such a way, the sitting place, the bodily requisition, brahmachari, celibacy, secluded place, and sitting straight and looking on the uppermost part of the nose. These are the sitting process, and mind should be concentrated on Vishnu. This is the meditation process. Evam sadatmana yogi niyatamanasa. Niyatamanasa means one who has best controlled his mind. The whole process is yogic process is simply to control the mind. Yoga, indriya sanyama, not only mind, but all the senses. All the senses, they should be under control. And controlling the senses, the mind should be engaged in Vishnu, within. Vishnu we have got, Paramatma, the Super Soul, Vishnu. And we have to concentrate in that way. Then, Shanti, Nirvana, Paraman, Moksha, Samadhi, then he becomes peaceful after extinguishing this material life. This material life is just like fire. It has been compared with the forest fire. As the forest fire automatically takes place, nobody goes to set fire. Similarly, in this material world, even you who try to live very peacefully and without quarreling with any other man, the place is such nuisance that he will not be able to live in peace anywhere, anywhere within this universe. That is the problem. But one who is transcendentally situated, either by the yogic process or by the process of empiric knowledge or by bhakti yoga, either of these processes, there may be a little difference at the ultimate end, but all these three processes, they are meant for transcendental life. So any process, if you make it perfect, then really you get peace. The only difference is that this yogic process as described in the Bhagavad Gita, it is not possible to be executed in this age. Therefore, the next alternative is this Hari Kirtan, as Lord Chaitanya recommends and devises. And you can practically see that this Kirtan, you can go on for hours together, you feel not tired. But if you are asked to sit down in the posture as recommended in the Bhagavad Gita for executing yoga system, hardly you can spare some minutes. So, Shanti Nirvanam, Parama, Matthana Vigacchi. And after extinguishing this material life, then what is next? Next is not void, is not impersonal void, as they say. Bhagavad Gita does not say like that. Bhagavad Gita says, Mastha-mastha-mastha-madhi-gacchati. He enters into my establishment. Sarastha means establishment. Now when you speak of establishment, suppose a big man, he has got establishment, that means it is not void. Establishment means there are varieties of engagement. unless it cannot be.
Samskara.
So, here it is clearly said that Masamskaram Adigachati, one attains to the kingdom of God, where spiritual varieties are there. They are not variety-less, otherwise the Lord would not have said that Samskaram. There is a regular establishment, just like you have got a regular establishment in your household affairs. Similarly, the Lord has a regular household establishment in the spiritual world. If these processes are simply to qualify himself to enter into that establishment, that's all. We are all belong to that establishment. But being forgetful, we are now in this material world. Just like sometimes some of us become crazy and he goes to the lunatic asylum. Similarly, those who become crazy, so spiritual identities, they are put into this lunatic asylum, what is called material world. This is the thought of lunatic asylum. Everything is being done not very safely, you see. So we have to get out of this lunatic asylum and enter into the kingdom of God, Sri Krishna. Now Sri Krishna is personally teaching what is his kingdom, what he is, what he was, and what is the relationship with Krishna. This everything is being taught in the Bhagavad Gita, and a sane man, an intelligent man, must take advantage of these processes. Then, Lord Krishna says, Natas, Natas, Natasya Jurasti. Anyone who eats more than necessary, or he cannot perform yoga. Nāti asnatasya yogasti nāca oikāntam anasnata. If person, willfully trying to keep himself in starvation, he cannot perform yoga. Neither the person who eats more than he requires, he also cannot perform yoga. The eating process should be moderate, only for keeping the body and soul together, not for enjoyment of the tongue. But that is a real yogi process. But you cannot eat very palatable things, because as soon as palatable things come before us, naturally, if I take one, I must take two, three, four. So far yogis are concerned, they cannot take any palatable, desirable thing. They have to simply take only the necessity. Some of the yogis there was one yogi in Calcutta, of course, in a temple, in a sanctified place. He was taking once only a little punch of rice boiled with water at 3 o'clock in the afternoon he was taking. That was his food, nothing more. Nothing more. So, nāti asnatastu yogasti nasikānta masasnata nāti sapnasīlasta. If anyone dreams very much, or he cannot also execute. Now, here Sri Krishna does not say that there is dreamless sleep. Dreamless sleep cannot be possible. It is not possible. If somebody says dreamlessly, it is also another lunacy. No. Dream there must be, more or less. As soon as you go asleep, dream there must be. That may be good dream, bad dream, or for long time, or for little time, but dream there must be. But Krishna says that na cha uti sapna silasa. That means, one who dreams very much while sleeping, he cannot execute. Yoga. No, jagrata naiva kaarjana. And one who cannot sleep at night. I've got a young friend, he cannot sleep. for him it is not yoga, for yoga class it is not possible. He may not down here. sleep also required. He cannot remain without sleeping. That is also required. That means, somehow or other, you should keep your body fit. You should not eat more. You shall not voluntarily starve. You should not be voluntarily awake. And if you keep yourself peaceful, then you will not sleep, you will not dream also. Dream when the bile is very much agitated, then we see so many dreams due to the air which is coming out of agitated bile. And if you keep yourself peaceful, cool mind, cool head, cool, stomach, then there ordinary sleep. So here it is said that na cha oti sapna silasya jagrata naiva cha arjuna. Again he repeats, juktahar viharasya yoga cheshtasya yukta cheshtasya karmasya. Now, here again he says, yukta cheshtasya karmasya. Now, if a yogi has to go away from home, then where is the question of karma? That means, sometimes those who are practicing yoga at home, for him it is said that yukta cheshtasya karmasya. If you want to be a yogi at home, then your other engagement should be moderate. You cannot engage for earning your living very heavily and at the same time you can become a yogi. No, that is not. That is not possible. Yukta ahara viharasya. You should eat very moderately. You should gratify your senses very moderately. And your work should be anxiety-less, and you should not dream more, and you should not be awake. These are the rules. Then yoga process will be successful. Jada viniyatam chittam atmani eva avatishtate nispriya sarvakamibha yukta ittuchyate tada. Now, what is the sign that one has attained perfection in yoga? The Lord says, jada viniyatam chittam. Chittam means your heart or your consciousness. When it is self-controlled, consciousness is completely under your control. You do not become dependent on the dictation of your mind, but mind becomes under your control. Jada vinirtam chittam asvaniyeva avatishtate. And mind does not go out, because yogi's principal business is to think of Krishna or Vishnu always. So yogi cannot allow his mind to go out. That is possible in Krishna consciousness. When we are engaged in Krishna consciousness, always engaged in Krishna's service, naturally my mind cannot go out besides Krishna. Besides Krishna. The mind is automatically controlled. Nispriha sarvakamibha. And you shall have no desire for material sense gratification. Sarvakamibha. Kama means material desires. And sarva, all kinds of. That means, if you are in Krishna consciousness, then you have no other desires. So your desireless you cannot be. That is not possible. Desireless means, here it is clearly said, sarva kamebha. Kamebha means desire for sense gratification. That is to be purified. But desire to serve Krishna, That is very good, very nice thing. So we have to transfer the desire. This is called Krishna consciousness. That desire you cannot kill. It is not possible. I am a living being. Desire is my constant companion. So therefore Krishna consciousness means to purify the desire. Why? How is that? Without sarva-kama bhava, without desiring for material sense gratification, I can desire so many things for Krishna's service. There are so many things. Suppose, just like take for example, eating. Eating, we want palatable dishes. Very good. But you prepare the palatable foodstuff for Krishna. For Krishna, you prepare hundreds of palatable. Don't think that it is being prepared for me. Therefore, one who prepares foodstuff for Krishna, he has to take very precaution. That is being prepared for Krishna. Sometimes I therefore ask the students, don't touch your mouth, don't very cleanly, very sanctifiedly, because it is being prepared. So, now that desire that Krishna will eat such nice cake and such nice rice. So, the whole thing is prepared in Krishna consciousness, and when it is offered to Krishna, you taste. So your karma is already sacrificed, because in the, from the very beginning, you are thinking that it is being prepared for Krishna. You have no desire. But Krishna is so merciful that he gives you the foodstuff for your eating. So your desire is already fulfilled. You do not desire it, but Krishna's mercy is so that he can fulfill it. Nitya sarva-kamibhva yukta ityuchyate tada. At that time, when one has molded his life in such a way, then he is to be understood that he has attained perfection in the yoga system. Simply routine work, doing some exercise, that is not the yoga system as far as Bhagavad Gita is concerned. Now, yatha dīpa nivātastha nengate supamās mṛtaḥ yogina yatasittasya jñyato yogamātmanaḥ. Just like a lamp, when it is not agitated by the wind, the flame is straight. Similarly, the mind should not be agitated. That flame is very nice when it is stand straight without being moved by the wind. That flame is very nice. That example is given here. The flame is so susceptible to wind that a little agitation, it moves. So similarly, our mind is also so susceptible to material desire that a little movement can change the whole thing. Change. Buddhanta indriya grama vidyansa vikarshati. Little change. In the Vedic language, it is forbidden for a yogi or those who are transcendental, because he has to remain brahmachari pratisthita. Brahmachari, there are two kinds of brahmachari. One who is leading a complete celibacy, complete free from sex life. He is called brahmachari. Another brahmachari is grihastha brahmachari. He has got his wife, but he has no other understanding with any other woman. And that wife also only, relation with him is performed under regulation. He is also brahmachari. One who has his relationship with wife under rules and regulation and does not know any other woman, he is also brahmachari. That is also called brahmachari. And one who leads complete celibacy, that he is also brahmachari. So that brahmachari vrata is essential for yogi. Brahmachari vrata. Now, jatititva yogadatma, so that mind should not be agitated. He says, the mind should not be agitated. Suppose I am brahmachari. I am taking the bhav, brahmachari vrata sita. I have taken the bhav
that I will have no sex life in my life. Then mind may be agitated sometimes. So there are precautions. Precautions, it is said in the Vedic literature that one should be very careful about women. They are so much careful. Matra sasra dhitra va nam vittasane vaset. The prescription is that one should not sit alone, even with his mother, with his sister, and with his daughter. Balavan viyagam vidyam sabitasati. The mind is so, fragile, that even little they can take about. You see. So these things are prescription for the yogi. Yogi has to look into the prescription of the system.